Mayo Wynne Baxter is one of the region's largest and best established law firms. Through various mergers and acquisitions, the firm can trace its history back hundreds of years, although the named elements of the firm start in 1867 by Wynne Edwin Baxter. Wynne Baxter had a long and varied career, and whilst maintaining a law firm in his hometown of Lewes, he also had a practice and advertising agency in Cannon Street, London. In 1881, he became the first ever mayor of Lewes, having been the town's last high constable. He was elected the coroner for the county of Middlesex in December 1886, and then for the city of London, and during his time in office, he conducted the inquest into the deaths of 10 of Jack the Ripper's victims. Baxter was also appointed a life governor of the London Hospital, and in 1890 he conducted the inquest into the death of the hospital's most famous resident, Joseph Merrick, the Elephant Man. By 1906, Charles William Mayo had started practicing law in Eastbourne under the name Biggs, Mayo & Company, and in April 1925, William Gregory Perkins joined him in partnership to create Mayo & Perkins. October 2000 saw Mayo & Perkins merge with the much older firm Keane Marsland in Royal Tunbridge Wells. At the same time, the River Ouse burst its banks and flooded the Lewes office of Wynne Baxter Godfrey. On February 12, 2007, Mayo & Perkins and Wynne Baxter merged to create Mayo Wynne Baxter LLP. The firm began 2011 by moving their Lewes office from Dial House by the river, where they had been for more than 100 years, to modern purpose-built offices in Bell Lane. In January 2012, Mayo Wynne Baxter incorporated Alan Ticehurst Solicitors in East Grinstead, and the following year, Mayo Wynne Baxter incorporated Forest Row firm PR Vince, bringing the firm's headcount to around 200 people across six offices. Mayo Wynne Baxter takes a responsible attitude and goes beyond the minimum legal requirements to ensure that the firm's activities leave a positive impact on its suppliers, clients, community, staff, and environment. In recent years, Mayo Wynne Baxter has developed an enviable reputation for being a good corporate citizen that supports the communities it serves. The firm is particularly well known for its involvement with local charities, including sponsorship of large fundraising events, as well as direct participation by individual staff members. Chestnut Tree House is the county's only children's hospice and has been the firm's nominated charity in recent years. Mayo Wynne Baxter has been the headline sponsor of the annual Snowman Spectacular Ball and Best of British Lunch for 3 years, and these events have raised hundreds of thousands of pounds for deserving charities such as Chestnut Tree House and Rocking Horse.
Mayo Wynne Baxter sponsor many of the Rocking Horse social events that take place across the year, many of our corporate events by taking tables or sponsoring those events. One of the events that we've put on for the last few years, our Best of British Sporting Lunch, Mayo Wynne Baxter has sponsored for the last 4 years, helping to generate over £300,000 towards local causes. So they really are engaged. The wonder of it is that they invite their staff to choose which charities that they want to nominate for the ensuing year. So it means the whole firm is engaged in their charitable giving.
It's not just through corporate sponsorship that the firm supports worthy causes. Staff give up their time to volunteer and raise money too. The firm's charity champions organise staff events throughout the year to raise money, with activities ranging from baking competitions to car booting. Individuals at the firm do their bit for a broad range of charities, and fundraising events have recently included bathtub racing and dancing competitions. Mayo Wynne Baxter's corporate social responsibility programme goes beyond supporting good causes, and the firm is active in supporting entrepreneurship and startups across the region.
Neil James have recently been working with Mayo Wynne Baxter on a local project called the LEAP, which is the Lewes Enterprise Apprenticeship Scheme, whereby we've been working together and helping start-up businesses.
The firm is a main sponsor of the Young Startup Talent Competition, which is a community-based project whose aims are to help 16 to 25-year-olds with an entrepreneurial flair for business. Members of the firm also act as business mentors for new startup business ventures and visit schools, colleges and universities to talk to students about setting up businesses too. In recent years, the Mayo Wynne Baxter brand has been seen to support numerous events and projects across the region, including the Chambers of Commerce, charity events, arts projects, Child of Sussex Awards, Argus Angels Awards, Eastbourne Business Awards, Lewes Carnival, Pride, Brighton Marathon, South of England Agricultural Society, Student Awards at Sussex Downs College and Brighton University, Sussex Food and Drink Awards, and Eastbourne Youth Radio, amongst many others. These sponsorships show the firm's support for the communities that they serve. However, the firm also has a very strong connection with Sussex Sports. In 2012, Mayo Wynne Baxter became one of Brighton and Hove Albion's founding 1901 club members, later taking on the naming rights of one of the main lounges at the stadium and becoming one of the football club's main sponsors. Mayo Wynne Baxter became a major sponsor of Sussex County Cricket Club in 2012 and introduced the Mayo Wynne Baxter Executive Suite, which holds up to 400 executive club members on match days. In 2013, the firm took the naming rights to the Executive Suite at Crawley Town Football Club to create a dominant presence at the stadium. This venue is used almost every day as a meeting space and even as a wedding venue. The firm's commitment to Sussex Sport can be seen at many other clubs and venues across the county, including Lewes Hockey Club, Brighton Racecourse, Lewes Football Club, and Eastbourne Hockey Club. One of Mayo Wynne Baxter's strengths is its ability to listen to its staff, its clients, and those that refer work to the firm.
We use Mayo Wynne Baxter for our legal work because of their expertise and because of the quality of their service, and we feel, most importantly, the availability and approachability of their staff. They really do put all of our legal aspects into everyday language that we can much more easily understand. And that makes our work at Brighton Dome and Brighton Festival all the easier.
I use Mayo Wynne Baxter for my legal work because I trust them. And running a small business these days means I'm very busy and I need to be well represented and know that everything's getting looked after. And they do that very well.
My first impressions of Mayo Wynne Baxter were that they were quite forward thinking. They valued their staff and their clients, and I felt they were quite inclusive. They care about training and development, and that's important to me.
Well, the main reason I recommend Mayo Wynne Baxter is the fact that quite simply they do what they say they're going to do. In business, that managing expectations for the client is absolutely key. And I dealt with Mayo Wynne Baxter as a client before I was referring them to other businesses. And every time they said they'd call me back at 3 o'clock, it was 3 o'clock, it wasn't half past. And the ability to just to commit to do what they say they're going to do speaks absolute volumes in terms of giving me confidence to refer them to other suppliers and businesses.
I would recommend Mayo Wynne Baxter to many of my clients for a number of reasons. One of those reasons would be the specialisms that they have within the firm. For instance, they have a great rural business team headed up by Simon Bailey Hamilton, who I found offers real practical advice, professional and with a smile.
As far as being a partner is concerned, I would say that it does create a mixture of feelings and responses. There are risks involved because afterwards the partner's money which is on the line if things aren't going well. There are responsibilities. When we faced the merger, I particularly was aware that for every member of staff we had, it was a household and a mortgage, and we were making big decisions that would change everybody's lives, including ours. But fortunately, there are rewards, and there are rewards in being good employers, there are rewards in doing financially well, and also in knowing that we're leaving the firm in a good shape.
Mayo Wynne Baxter's brand statement is exceptional service from outstanding people, and the firm prides itself on the high levels of client service that it delivers. The firm has a number of ways of measuring its service delivery, the first of which is through a client satisfaction questionnaire, or CSQ. These CSQs are sent to a client upon completion of work and ask about the service they have received. Each return CSQ is carefully analysed and used to identify any training needs at the firm before being collated and published on the firm's website.
As head of department, I see every customer service questionnaire that comes back into my department. I also see quite a few that go to elsewhere in the firm. So I know from seeing those that our clients see us as a very professional firm, very friendly, and a firm which tries to make the transaction as quick and easy to understand as possible.
In the first 6 months of 2013, an average of 98.8% of responders rated the service as satisfied or very satisfied. Responders are also asked if they would be happy to receive a call from a quality consultant to discuss their experience in more detail.
I introduced the Quality Consultant Programme because I thought we needed to get a bit more information in an in-depth way from clients about all the things we were doing well and the things where we needed to improve our service a little to make sure we really hit the quality high spots.
Mayo Wynne Baxter is also one of the few law firms to also publish a detailed service level agreement so that potential clients know what the minimum level of service is that they can expect. This agreement covers the firm's commitment to speed of response, fee arrangements, how cases will be handled, and how any concerns will be dealt with. To further test that the firm is delivering on these promises, it uses an independent mystery shopping company who regularly checks its service. This commitment to delivering the highest standards of service has been acknowledged by the Law Society, highly commending it in its annual Excellence Awards, which recognises the most outstanding legal practitioners across the entire legal sector in England and Wales. Mayo Wynne Baxter is also one of only a small number of firms to achieve Lexel accreditation, which is awarded to those law firms that reach a standard of excellence in their practice management. Mayo Wynne Baxter continues to flourish despite operating in a highly competitive market. Its success is a testament to their dedicated staff, innovative approach, expert advice, and above all, its client focus.
The three words that I'd use to describe Mayo Wynne Baxter are forward thinking, loyalty and service.
Reliable, trustworthy and professional.
Proactive, innovative and diverse.
Loyal, approachable and committed.
Dedicated, thorough and professional.
I see the future for Mayo Wynne Baxter to be very positive and very encouraging. I think we will continue to do very well and build on the successes of the past.
I think the future for Mayo Wynne Baxter is really exciting. No doubt they are operating in a very challenging climate and very competitive industry, but they are very much well placed with the experience that they hold to continue to be successful.
The future looks very, very bright for Mayo Wynne Baxter.